Well, about 2 weeks ago, Catamount Country got some good news. Men's lacrosse coach Chris Feifs, he's sticking around.
Yeah, we sat down with Feifs to talk about how his extension went and how the team is preparing for the upcoming campaign.
You guys are kind of in the thick of your fall ball workouts. What's it been like just kind of getting the new guys in here, kind of seeing what you've got in terms of the returners and kind of getting ready for your new season coming up here starting in February?
It's been awesome. I mean, we're highly motivated the way the season ended last year. The guys are not lacking motivation. They're coming out every morning at 6 a.m., working extremely hard. And so many new faces on the defensive end of the field especially has created a giant vacuum. And, you know, trying to create some leadership on both sides of the ball with a lot of new faces and a new assistant coach as well. So it's been awesome.
Announcement coming from the program within the last couple of days that you've signed an extension. You're now locked in here through 2027. What was the process like in that? What were the discussions like? And what was the decision like for you to extend and stay here in Catamount Country?
Yeah, I mean, you know, working with Jeff Schulman and just, you know, expressing my desire to be here for another 4 years was really amazing to have him, you know, come to the table and give a great offer to keep me here and just really relieved to be here for another 4 years. You know, we've worked so hard, all of us, my assistants, my staff, all of my players and alums and families, to take this to where it is now. And, you know, we're not finished. We're a long way from being finished. And a lot of our best milestones, I think, are still in front of us. So the next 4 years are going to be really, really exciting and really, really impactful for the future of Vermont lacrosse. And like I said, just relieved to be here.
That first weekend in May, hopefully even that second weekend in May, you're looking up at the scoreboard. You've won the games that you want to win. How did you get there?
We got there by coming together as a team and not relying too much on any one player, on whether it be a face-off guy, whether it be a middie, whether it be a goalie. You know, we've had some really impressive standout individual players here over the years. I think this is one of those years where we're going to have to be super unified and rely on all of our parts and just be a sum of our parts to beat some of these tough teams in league like Bryant, like UMBC, like Albany, who are really chomping at the bit to either stay at the top of the mountain or get back to the top of the mountain. And I think our culture's in a good place to do that. But we still have a long way to go with our systems and our skill work and, you know, figuring out the exact depth chart before the spring.